Yes.
43. Thus knowing oneself to be transcendental, the material senses, mind, and intelligence, one should control the lower self by the higher self, and thus, by spiritual strength, conquer this insatiable enemy known as lust. Purport. This third chapter of the Bhagavad Gita is conclusively directed to Krishna consciousness. Through knowing oneself as the eternal servitor of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, without considering impersonal voidness as the ultimate goal and ultimate end. In the material existence of life, one is certainly influenced by propensities of lust and desire for dominating the resources of material nature. Such desire for overlording and sense gratification are the greatest enemies of the conditioned soul. But by the strength...
Generally, those who are under the bodily concept of life, they are struggling day and night. Why? To have overlordship of this material nature. This is material activity. And those who are on the mental platform, they are trying to philosophize, mental speculation. Those who are still intelligent, they are taking to this yoga practice by intelligently trying to controlling the senses. But as soon as you come to the spiritual platform, automatically these things are done, because all your senses, mind and intelligence are occupied by Krishna consciousness. Yes, go on.
One may not give up work and prescribe duties all of a sudden, but by gradually developing one's Krishna consciousness, one can be situated in a transcendental position without being influenced by the material senses and the mind, by steady intelligence directed toward one's pure identity. This is the sum total of this chapter. In the immature stage of material existence, philosophical speculations and artificial attempts to control the senses by the so-called practice of yogic postures can never help a man toward spiritual life. He must be trained in Krishna consciousness by a higher intelligence. Thus ends the Bhaktivedanta purport to the third chapter of the Srimad Bhagavad Gita in the matter of karma yoga, or the acting of one's prescribed duty in Krishna consciousness.
Any question? Yes.
In your fourth purport of the 38th verse, you're talking about the tree, the position of the tree, how it is put in this position due to its previous engagement, exhibition of love.
Page.
Pardon? Page 106.
Yeah. Please. Read it. What? Well.
Living entities, but they have to put into that condition of life by by such a great exhibition of love that they are almost void of all consciousness.
Yes. So what is your question?
People that are engaged in lusty acts during their life, I thought that Kṛṣṇa is merciful and he will provide them with the body to have as much lust as they want. I can't see how a person could evolve into that body of a tree through engaging himself in lusty activity during their life.
I don't follow.
In the Bhagavad Gita it is stated that whatever one's consciousness is during his lifetime will be at the time of his death, and that will determine his next body.
Yes.
Now one who is very lusty, living very lustily during his lifetime, his mind will be on his body.
Yes.
So
there are many kind, there are varieties of life. Just like somebody is very lusty and he wants sex enjoyment so many times a day. So there are many animals, many birds, they are given the opportunity like that. Just like the pigeons, the sparrows, or there are many birds, these swans, the ducks, they have got every day 20 times sex intercourse. So this facility is given to them. You see. Similarly, somebody wants to eat meats and blood, he is given the chance to become a tiger. So Kṛṣṇa is giving chance to everyone. And one who is very dull, cannot understand simply the sense gratification they are making, they are made the dullest possible, like trees stand up for thousands of years. So all these different varieties of life, 8,400,000, we have got different varieties. There's, you can calculate, there are three qualities. 3 × 3 = 9. 3 × 3 becomes 9. And 9 × 9 becomes 81. Automatically it becomes more than 8 million. So, God's kingdom, His calculation, His fine judgment is very difficult to understand. But practically we see there are so many varieties of life. Why? They have been given chance. All right. You want this sort of life? Here it is. Take it. Accept it. So they are transmigrating from one life to another. Out of many such millions of living entities, one who comes under Kṛṣṇa consciousness by the grace of Kṛṣṇa and his devotee, spiritual master, his life is successful. He gets the clue to get out of this entanglement. Otherwise, he is to travel within these 8,400,000 of species of life. So Kṛṣṇa is giving chance, whatever you want. But he is talking also the ultimate goal of your life. Sarvadharmān parityajyamāmekaṁ saranvai. You give up this searching out of your happiness in your own way by transmigrating from one kind of life to another, one position to another. You just take shelter of me and I take charge of you. This is the whole proposition of Bhagavad Gita. This is Kṛṣṇa consciousness. One has to give up searching out of happiness according to his own plan, but he has to submit himself to Kṛṣṇa who will take charge and will give you all happiness that you deserve. That is Krishna consciousness.
Are the people in this age thus they are always in the world of ignorance, or are they thus they are not free?
This the anyone who is in the material world, he is lusty. Maybe difference of degrees, that doesn't matter. But he is lusty. Kamayasa krodhayasa rajaguna samadbha. Everyone is trying to lord it over the material nature. That is lust. Now, the ant is trying to lord it over the material nature in his own way, and the big politician, he is trying to lord it over the material nature in a different way. Everyone is trying. So that lording it over the material nature is the sign of lust. So you can take it for granted that anyone who is within this material world, he has got that contamination of lust. Maybe manifested in divine degrees. But who has come to Krishna consciousness, he has no more lust. Because he wants to satisfy Krishna. He doesn't want to satisfy his senses. That is Krishna consciousness. His aim of life is how Krishna will be pleased. That's all. And lust means how my senses will be satisfied. That is the difference. The process of satisfying is going on. In our conditioned life, we are trying to satisfy our senses. And in our Krishna consciousness life, we are satisfying to satisfy. Please Krishna. That is the difference. So my work is not stopped, but the goal of life is changed. That is liberation. We don't say that you kill your desire. No. You purify your desire to satisfy Krishna. That's all. Now your desire is to satisfy your senses. That's all. This has to be purified, that you shall desire, but you should desire to satisfy Krishna. Then your perfection. In one way it is very simple and easy, because I know how to satisfy my senses. I am doing it. Life after life, the same endeavor should be engaged for satisfying Krishna. That's all. The process has not to be learned by me. I know it. Simply account has to be changed. That's all. So Krishna consciousness is very simple and easy. Immediately you come to the spiritual platform or transcendental platform. That is explained in the Chaitanya Charitamrita. Lust and love. What is the difference between lust and love? In the material world there is no love. Because everyone is directed by lust, the so-called love. A young boy is trying to love a young girl, or a young girl is trying to love a young. But the background is lust. There is no love. It is simply a show of love. Therefore, after satisfying lust, there is divorce, there is separation. So in the material world there is no possibility of love. It is all lust. Love is only possible when you love God. There is no lust. There is no question of sense gratification. Simply for love. Kṛṣṇa is my lover, Kṛṣṇa is my master, Kṛṣṇa is my friend. Just like Arjuna. Arjuna is loving Kṛṣṇa as friend. So he's so great lover that in the beginning he hesitated to fight, how shall I kill my kinsman? But when he understood, Kṛṣṇa my friend desires, oh, never mind. So there was no lust, simply love of Kṛṣṇa. So lust and love, that means the same thing is there. Simply one has to change the account, that's all. Lusty people, they are working on account of sense gratification. And lover of Kṛṣṇa is working for Krishna's satisfaction. The activity may appear superficially the same. Just like these boys in Krishna consciousness, people may say, what they are doing? They are also eating, they are also cooking and offering Krishna. And they say, this Krishna consciousness, what is the difference between this food stuff and the hotel food stuff? In this way they may think, oh, they are also typewriting, they are also using dictaphone and this tape recorder and all this material. But they do not know that everything is being used for Krishna. Therefore there is far difference. There is no lust. So you can utilize everything if it is in Krishna consciousness, not for satisfaction of your lust. Then your life is sublime. We do not reject anything. But we accept anything. The only difference is that we do not accept anything for our sense gratification. We do not accept this tape recorder for sense gratification, singing or dancing. We accept this tape recorder to record Krishna's glories, to record Krishna's topics. So this is the difference only. Nidbande Krishna Sambandhe Jukta Vairagya Muchyat. Dovetail everything in Krishna consciousness and it is perfect. And dovetail anything with your lust or sense gratification, apparently it may be very good, nice thing, but it is nonsense, it is lust. So somebody is using religion for satisfaction of his senses. Somebody is using Bhagavad Gita for satisfaction of his senses. We do not wish to discuss all this in detail. But actually there is no training how to use things in Krishna consciousness. That is being now introduced in this movement, Krishna consciousness. How to make everything perfect, dovetail in Krishna consciousness. So, any other questions?
Purports that they are, they have been very lusty. this tends to show that they have been once before in human form and then have really fallen. But is it also the case that there are amongst the forms many souls that are on the process of evolution and going upward?
Yes, just like you are stepping some staircases. You go to the second floor or third floor, but somewhere you fall down again. So you have to cross again the steps. Do you follow? That does not mean because you crossed all the steps and went to the third floor, now you have fallen down. You have to cross again. So there is a regular evolutionary process from trees to worms, reptiles, from reptiles to birds, from birds to bees, varieties of bees, and from bees to human life. These are the stepping stone evolutionary process. But even if you are human being, if you fall down to the category of the trees, then you have to again go up, step by step. You have to come to the form of the worms and reptiles, then birds, then bees. Therefore we should not miss this chance. This is intelligence. If I miss this chance, then I do not know where I am falling down again. So there is no teaching, there is no knowledge in the whole world. They are driven out just like animals. These educational institutions, universities, there is no department of knowledge how the living entities are working, how they are being transmitted, how they are falling down, how they... No. A very risky civilization. The people should try to understand this Krishna consciousness philosophy very seriously. If they at all want their own good. From trees, the worms. Do you see it? From the flower there are some butterflies. You have seen? The flowers generate some worms and they transform into butterfly. You have seen it. Then gradually they will become birds from butterfly. And from birds, different birds, then they will become beasts, four-legged. And then the four legs turn into two hands and just like gorilla, monkey. Then you will come to this beautiful form. And if you miss this opportunity, again you want to become butterfly. Go on. We'll check you. Become butterfly. Nature will not excuse you. As soon as you want to become butterfly, yes, come on. Here it is. They do not know. They are thinking, this is a flickering life, oh, let us enjoy. Very risky civilization. Jalaja navalakkhani sthavara lakkhavingsati. These are all stated in the Puranas. These books were meant for human society. They are not reading. They are reading all rascal novels and literatures and sex life frauds and these and that. How they are wasting their time. The other day, Govindas was showing me one literature, Hawaii, a picture, the boys and girls, they are enjoying this, what is called, this surface, spending money, you see. But there is no instruction how they are wasting their time, this human form of life, simply by jumping in the water. And they think I'm enjoying butterfly. They do not know the value of this life. And the system of civilization is encouraging them to do this without any good information. What kind of condemned civilization is that? Pulling by force to the darkest region of hell. They do not know. Although the hellish condition of life is in the front, there are so many varieties of life. They do not question where from these lives come. The Padma Purana says, Jalajanavalakhani sthavara lakhavinsati krimayo rudra sankhaka. There are Navalokkhani, 900,000 species of life within water. We begin our aquatic life because the whole world was in the beginning full of water. So we had to live within the water. So there are 900,000 species of life within the water. Jalajana Valakhani, Sthavara Lakhavinsati. And when the water dries up, as soon as the land comes out, the trees and plants begin to grow. 2 million types of trees and plants. In this way, there are 8,400,000 of species of life. What do they know? The botanist and the biologist. So, it is very serious. People should take it very seriously, Krishna consciousness movement. It is not a humbug thing. It is based on authorized scriptures, Vedic literature. Unfortunately, you have no customer for this knowledge.
Doesn't Krishna take any special mercy on flowers that all offer?
Yes, when it is offered to Krishna. Yes, therefore you offer flowers to Krishna. We are doing service to the flowers.
Where will they take their nectar? They don't become butterflies.
That will be understood later on. First of all, because it has come to Krishna, there is something good. The tree which has produced this flower, he is benefited. Because he is offering his energy. Krishna consciousness means offering one's energy to Krishna. The energy is derived from Krishna. It should be offered to Krishna. Just like, what is this water? Water is taken from the ocean. Derived from the ocean, it goes to the sky, again turns into water, falls down, and in river goes down again to the ocean. Similarly, we have derived our energy from Krishna. Now, again, if we glide down towards Krishna, that is perfect. We haven't got separate energy. This is Krishna consciousness. To apply the whole energy towards Krishna. That's all. That energy may be utilized in different ways. but to Kṛṣṇa. This is Kṛṣṇa consciousness. Chant Hare Kṛṣṇa.